The Philippine Central Bank seen staying on hawkish pause, keeping policy rates steady at 6.5% when it meets for the last time this year on Thursday, December 14th. Most central banks across the world are expected to stay higher for longer. For much longer, in fact, because while the upward pressure on prices of key commodities like food and fuel have eased, they remain elevated. Meanwhile, the Department of Agriculture says prices of nearly all agricultural products remain stable ahead of the Christmas and New Year festivities, except for some, like tilapia, which went up by 5 pesos to 145 per kilo. Eggs, which saw a spike in recent months, is now back to 750 per medium piece. Rice also stable between 51 and 52 pesos per kilo. Consumers will also enjoy lower energy prices this month. Meralco has announced an 80 centavo per kilowatt hour cut in power rates for the December billing. That's equivalent to 159 to 398 peso reduction in bills for consumers using 500 kilowatts per month. This is due to lower prices at the spot market owing to minimal plant shutdowns and steady supply. The Philippine government's national spending plan for 2024 now up for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s approval. Both the House and the Senate sticking to their earlier decision of stripping civilian agencies of confidential funds. RG Cruz has more.
The bicameral conference committee made about 449 billion pesos in net changes when it approved the committee report reconciling the Senate and House versions of the 5.768 trillion peso 2024 budget. Among the changes, 60 billion pesos to fund some 5,000 pesos in cash assistance to the near poor or those earning 23,000 pesos or less monthly.
More or less, mga 12 million households ang target beneficiaries natin sa programang ito, which includes construction workers, drivers, factory workers, and the likes.
Existing financial assistance programs will continue, even as a housing subsidy was also included. There were no changes to the budget of the Office of the President and Office of the Vice President as approved by the House. The panel sustained the House's removal of the confidential funds of the Office of the Vice President, Department of Education, and other civilian agencies, though the Department of Information and Communication Technology got additional funds for cybersecurity. The panel also sustained the ban on the use of the contingent fund as a confidential fund. The Department of Education and the state universities and colleges got more. That includes the University of the Philippines. More funds were given to the Department of Health along with the funds to finish the building of hospitals promised by the government. Though the Department of Agriculture saw a reduction, more funds were allotted for assistance to farmers for seeds, fertilizer, and other inputs. There's also 60 billion pesos for irrigation projects and 25 billion for other crops.
If we put the education, the yung legacy po on the hospital, which is the specialty hospital, the legacy on food security, which is DA under NIA irrigation, we doubled the funding. We put around almost 40 to 60 billion sa irrigation.
The Department of Public Works and Highways and Department of National Defense also got huge increases, among others.
Actually, hindi ko nga nabanggit kanina nung tinanong earlier yung mga spending priorities na nag-increase. Yung defense budget pala increased also.
While the Department of Transportation saw a significant reduction, congressional leaders hope to have the president sign the budget before year-end. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Ayala Healthcare Holdings, or AC Health, raising its stake in the Healthway QualiMed Network to 94% from 70%, signifying a renewed commitment to advance healthcare in the country. The network, which originally encompassed 4 general hospitals, 1 ambulatory surgical center, and multiple clinics nationwide, has been Ayala's focus on its improvement initiatives since it acquired a majority stake back in 2020. AC Health also recently inaugurated the Healthway Cancer Care Hospital, the country's first dedicated specialty hospital for cancer patients. It's also set to open 3 new multi-specialty centers in the Philippine provinces of Cagayan de Oro, Davao, and Cebu by the end of this year. Now, the Transportation Department assuring air passengers the January 1 fiasco won't happen again. This as aviation agencies gear up for the holiday break. Philippine Airlines, meanwhile, announcing plans to fly direct to another U.S. city. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista assures the public the January 1 closure of the Philippine airspace is unlikely to happen again. He says improvements have been made in various airport processes and equipment are properly maintained.
We have already improved all the equipment, no? All the necessary maintenance procedures are being implemented, no? The employees, the officers of CAAP are very much aware of my instructions to them to see to it that all equipments should be working.
A power outage in January caused the closure of the Philippine airspace, canceling hundreds of flights and affecting thousands of passengers flying back following the New Year celebration. Aside from air traffic control, the Manila International Airport Authority is also ready for the possible influx of passengers in the coming weeks. MIAA OIC Brian Ko, however, notes the number of passengers will likely be spread out over the two-week break.
We had to make sure we have enough resources, nandito rin mga tao, ang mga equipment na nakakabit sa NAIA, tuloy-tuloy ang ating pag-upgrade, at syempre ang security.
Flag carrier Philippine Airlines also is expecting a 15 to 20% increase in the number of passengers this December. At the Christmas tree lighting ceremony at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 1, PAL President and COO Stanley Nang reveals they have a hard time adding more flights due to limited aircraft.
Naging problem pa rin natin this time is really the supply chain. You know? So even we want to mount more flights to provide access, but the problem really is limited by the supply chain issue. So we can only add a few additional flights lang.
Limited aircraft also means a pause in its expansion plans in Europe. But Nang says they are expecting more lease planes to arrive next year and brand new planes by 2025. PAL is instead looking to add a new destination in the United States by the third quarter of next year. Nang refuses to divulge where, but hints it will most likely be in the West Coast.
Sa US, may possibility na maka-launch tayo ng additional destination na isa. Pinag-aaralan pa nila, if we get the planes already, the Airbus 351,000, then that's the time that we can look for long-haul destinations.
Nang says the entry of United Airlines has so far not negatively affected PAL. PAL, which recently inked an expanded code share agreement with Singapore Airlines, is also in talks with another major airline for another similar partnership. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
A recruitment solutions provider aims to address the widening job skill mismatch in the Philippines. Singapore-based CMECV recently partnered with the Philippine Trade Department to help upskill the workforce amid a rise in underemployment in the country. CMECV says through its platform, it can help both job seekers and employers by matching talent and demand real time.
Today we're having a mismatch and a disconnect. I spoke at a healthcare event a couple of months ago, and on one side of the story is that there are a lot of nurses going overseas, and that's leaving the domestic market short of qualified nurses to support public and private services in the Philippines. And there's a big outcry to make sure that that talent didn't go overseas. But at the same time, there's a surplus of 124,000 nurses who are underemployed or unemployed. Through our platform, we can identify those 124,000 nurses. We can look at their skills and offer them to the industry or advise them along the skills frameworks to seek further training through public or private services to upskill so they're re-enabled to rejoin the workforce.
Hungarians get into the Christmas spirit by stripping down, braving temperatures of barely just above freezing. Nearly 100 people donned Christmas-themed swimsuits and Santa hats for the 20th Budapest Half-Naked Santa Run. Cheering and shouting, ho, 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 runners made their way across the city center, where they also made frequent stops for exercise and dancing. The fun is all for a cause. Organizers will donate participation fees to charity, with this year's proceeds going to a foundation which supports families raising severely premature babies with disabilities.